When we held the first summit last August, enabling technology was still a concept here in Tennessee. A lot's changed in a year. We've seen how it impacts people on an individual level. Our goal this year is to see how we might be able to impact the entire network with introduction and providing access to these technologies to people across the board.
In order to understand where we are today, that you have to take a look at where we've been in Tennessee. Technology is going to be exciting. More people are going to be served. They're going to be served with less restrictions. It's the right direction. It's the natural direction. So.
You have to have great expectations. I think that is absolutely critical. Go in with great expectations that individuals with differing abilities can learn to access technology for whatever use and purpose that they're going to use it for. This is my daughter, Kara. She always, from the get-go, was very, very independent. Kara was so determined that she was going to live on her own, and we thought, well, let's try it and see what will happen. I started thinking about technology as a way to support Kara.
I follow my voice reminders to help me succeed.
Having that technology in itself is not going to solve the problem. You have to be able to bring your organization and your staff to that level where they're going to be able to use it effectively and efficiently.
We're there to help better them, to give them the tools necessary to have the best, most independent life possible.
It's a quote from one of our enabling technology videos. No matter how much credit you're giving somebody, they're more capable than you think they are. That statement in and of itself permeates this movement from the ground up.
I would recommend anybody to try it, because once you see how well it works, I mean, they can do anything that we can do.